Thank you. Because you want to go, I just do thank God for being here, thank God for life, for health, for strength. Thank God for His many blessings. We thank and praise the Lord just for being a wonderful Savior.
Amen.
For being a good God and a merciful God. We thank God for all things because the Lord has been good. He's been a way maker.
Amen.
He's been a healer.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
He's been a comforter. We just thank and praise God for all that He has done. Amen.
Amen.
Because without the Lord, we would have no hope today, saints.
Amen.
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 Amen. You know, people often say people try to live without the Lord in their life. And what happens is they find out they can't do it.
Amen. That's true.
They find out that, amen, they need help.
Yes, Lord.
They find out whether they have money or not.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. They're still not satisfied.
Amen.
With the things of this world.
Yes.
Amen, because there's a spot in each and every one of us.
Yes.
Only the Lord can fill.
Amen.
And the Word of God lets us know, you must be born again.
Amen.
You can't run away from it.
Amen.
Amen, I believe the psalmist said, where should I flee from the presence of the Lord?
Yes.
Amen, I believe that was King David that wrote that. Amen. Where can I flee from the presence of the Lord?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
If I'm going to the highest mountain, can't do it. If I go under, amen, the deepest cave, I can't do it.
Well,
in other words, there's nowhere for me to hide from, amen, the presence of the Lord. God is everywhere at all times.
Amen.
Amen. And we're going to have to give an account in Jesus' name. Amen. For the deeds done in this body, in this life, in Jesus' name. Amen. But guess what? The good news is there's hope.
Yes.
Amen.
In Christ Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And so we have a hope today. Amen.
Yes.
We're talking about reconciliation. Amen. In Christ. Because we've been reconciled to Christ.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
We can lead others to be reconciled unto the Lord.
Amen.
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 Amen. And that is our job. Amen. The gospel is the ministry of reconciliation.
Yes.
Amen. So we thank and praise God. And family, truly God is a good counselor. To everybody but the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There's nothing wrong with sharing your feelings with somebody.
Amen.
But make sure you checked in with the Lord.
Right. That's right. Hallelujah.
But when you share your feelings with somebody, it might make you feel good.
Well,
give you a sense of empathy.
Yes.
That they have a sense of empathy for your situation, that is. But that's not going to solve your problem.
Well,
you need to take it to the one that can solve the problem.
Amen.
And that can bring you out.
Hallelujah.
And so many of us today,
Jesus,
we try to avoid the Lord.
Uh-huh.
We want things in life.
Mm.
We want things to turn out right.
Mm.
But we refuse to surrender to God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes.
Now, about a question for the world, say, how's that working for you?
Yeah.
It's not working too good. Amen.
Yeah.
Opioid epidemic, you see it today all over the place. Because folks have no peace, no rest.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Relationships breaking up because folks have no peace, no rest.
Yeah.
Amen. Children killing themselves because they have no peace, no rest. Amen. Because we don't take our problems to the Lord.
Amen.
And then we don't trust Him to solve our problems.
Amen.
We look for everybody else to do it except the one that can do something about our problems.
Amen.
I find out, amen, when you put your trust in the Lord, He will work it out.
Yes.
Sometimes He'll give you grace to go through that problem.
Yes.
He's not always going to remove it. So we have to be able to accept what thus saith the Lord.
Amen.
And sometimes what God says does not match what we want.
Yes.
Sometimes we go looking for a certain answer, but we have to say, Lord, thy will be done.
Amen.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Yes.
We have to be willing to accept what thus saith the Lord.
Jesus.
You know, Lord, I want you to heal me, Lord, but if you don't heal me, give me grace to go through.
Amen.
Lord, I don't want to go through this situation, but Lord, if I have to, give me strength to go through and learn how to trust you, Lord.
Amen.
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 Amen. Folks don't want to say that. They say, Lord, take it away. Lord, take it away. And when God don't take it away, well, God didn't come through for me. I can't depend on God because he didn't take the pain away. He didn't take the struggle away. And that's what I was looking forward to. But you know, you have to be willing to accept what thus saith the Lord.
Amen.
That's right.
Because sometimes God put us through a situation as a test.
Mm-hmm.
And we're not willing to believe God.
Yes.
Amen. We're going to throw up our hands. Amen. And to all those people that say, well, I tried the Lord and it didn't work. I told him, no, he didn't.
Right.
I tried the Lord and my life is a mess.
Yes.
Then you really didn't try the Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
But I'm going to let you know my life can be a mess sometime. But I tried the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And he worked it out.
Yes.
Amen.
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 He worked it out in Jesus' name. That's the difference.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
The reason is you have to realize the battle is not yours.
That's right.
It belongs to God.
Yes. Amen.
Folks want to surrender to the Lord. Lord, I can't fight this battle. I can't do this, Lord. Hey, my God. Hey. Hallelujah. Hey. These walls, Lord, are too tall for me to break down by myself. God said, that's all right.
Amen.
Hey. My God. Hallelujah. I made those walls.
Yes.
God said that I can bring them down.
Amen.
In your life.
Amen.
I can bridge the gap. But you got to be willing to trust God.
Amen.
How many are willing to trust God?
Yes.
You say you know God, but if you know God, you have to go through something with the Lord.
Amen.
Make no mistake about it.
Amen.
That's what a testimony is. A testimony is not getting up and saying some words that sound nice.
Well,
but a testimony is a life lived.
Amen.
I've been through, but God brought me through.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I've been sick, but the Lord healed my body.
Hallelujah.
I'm yet going through, but God has given me grace to go through.
Amen.
I'm yet being persecuted, but I got joy on the inside. Saints, you got to trust the Lord.
Amen.
Bible said, pray without ceasing.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Pray what? Take it to the Lord.
Amen.
The reason why, amen, it sounds simplistic, but it's true. The reason why folks in this world are having so much trouble, because they really haven't surrendered to God.
Amen.
When you surrender to the Lord will work things out for you. When you pray fervently. Fervently to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I'm not talking about, Lord Jesus, I'm having trouble. I want you to help me, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Amen. That ain't going to go nowhere.
Uh-huh.
But you got to cry out to the Lord.
Amen.
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 Amen. You got to cry. You got to empty out your soul to the Lord.
Yes, that's right.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
You got to empty out your soul and cry out to the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord said, these things have happened, Lord. And even if you think, well, there's no working it out, I'm here to tell you, God can work it out.
Amen.
You know, sometimes I wish some of us would just say, Lord, I'm going to put you to the test, Lord. Talk to the Lord.
Yeah.
Lord, I'm going to do what you say, Lord. And I'm believing that you're going to work this situation out.
Amen.
Even, Lord, when that situation seems to be broken.
Yes.
God can fix it.
Amen.
Amen. We looked at the example, I think he gave the example of the Apostle Paul. Before he became the Apostle Paul, he was Saul.
Yes.
And he was the most strident adversary to the gospel.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes,
amen. It was literally life or death.
Amen.
But the Spirit of God, amen, met him on the road to the
ministry. That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
And he realized, it's God said, it is I, Jesus.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Amen.
It is I, Jesus.
That's right.
You know, he was humble and he surrendered to God.
That's right.
He didn't keep on fighting. He said, Lord, what would you have me to do? And uh-huh. God humbled him.
Amen.
See, a lot of times we're not willing to be humbled by God.
Yes.
We want everything to be put on a plate for us and everything's going to work out just like that. But a lot of times we got to be humbled by the Lord.
Amen.
In order that things will work out for us.
Yes.
Amen. We got to be willing, Lord Jesus Christ, help me, Lord. I'm yours. And sometimes that part of that I'm yours means, Lord, I'm willing to do whatever.
Amen.
And when a person get on the altar, amen, they have to be surrendered to God.
That's right.
Lord, I'm willing, Lord, I'm going to do whatever they say. If they tell me to jump, I'm going to jump. If they tell me to run from here, I'm going to do that, Lord.
Yes,
whatever
sir.
They tell me to do, I'm going to do, because why? I want the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
A surrendered heart to the Lord.
Yes.
Lord, I'm willing to do anything in Jesus' name and all that I might receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
But when you fight, when you're trying to figure it out on your own, and you always got questions all the time, amen. The Bible said a double-minded person will get nothing from God.
Amen.
Amen. But if you have a mind to do right, if you have a mind to do right, if you learn to trust in God, amen, God will see it through.
Amen.
You see, the problem is today, folks trying to work it out, amen, do their own thing, figure things out on their own.
Mm-hmm.
That's why there's so much trouble in this world, because they try to do everything on their own.
Yeah.
That's why there's so much strife in this world. They call broken relationship because they try to do everything on their own.
Amen.
But amen, I want you to understand something. Amen. You have to be willing to trust in the Lord.
Amen.
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 The Sunday school lesson this morning, I'm not making it up. Amen. We're talking about, amen, when it comes to irreconcilable differences. That's what people say. They use that when they have a broken relationship. One thing about marriage, and I tell people all the time, when you're in a marriage, anybody that tells you it's 50-50 is living in dreamland. Amen? Because the reality is this. Sometimes your wife has to go 95 and you go 5. That's reality. Sometimes you got to go 95. Even when you think you're right, you still got to go 95 and she'll go 5.
That's right.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. It's a gift. Why? Because you made a vow to God.
That's right.
And because you made a vow to God, you got to be able to keep that vow. And it's not easy.
No, it's not.
But when you learn to trust in God, it makes a difference.
Amen.
God can heal in any kind of relationship. The Lord, amen, can heal. He's a God of reconciliation.
Amen.
I remember you and I once. Amen. We're not reconciled to God.
That's true.
We were outside. We were opposed to God. We were living an ungodly life.
Amen.
Amen.
But the Lord in his infinite mercy, he said what? When he looked at the people, he was moved with compassion.
Amen.
Because he not only saw their physical need, they were hungry, but they were also hungry spiritually for the word.
Amen.
And that's what Jesus saw. And that was their real need.
Yes.
Because after a while, after they ate, they would still be hungry physically.
Yes.
Amen. No matter how much you eat right now, eventually, you're going to get hungry again.
Yes, that's true.
But as he told the woman at the well, he said, the water that I give you, when you drink of this water, you ain't going to thirst no more.
Yes.
Yes. Amen?
Yes,
God said, when you drink of this, the problem is people are still drinking of the natural water of this world.
Yes.
And it does not satisfy what you need in your life is a spiritual water.
Yes.
That's the thing that's going to satisfy you.
Yes.
Because without that, you got nothing.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
That's what Jesus was trying to convey.
Yes.
That's what the Word of God is trying to tell people today.
Amen.
You're not going to get around God.
No.
Amen?
Amen.
No matter how, let me tell you. Amen. Look, this morning they had the news. Amen. We're going to go on the service. Had the news of them. Amen. The senator.
Amen.
81 years old, McCain.
Yes.
That died. Now you think about it. He had the best health care in the world. He could afford.
Oh, yeah.
Anything. Let me tell you, he had money. Don't make nobody fool you. These folks got some money. They can afford the best doctors, the latest treatment. But guess what? At a certain point, he knew.
That's right.
He had to die.
Amen.
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 And I would, like I was saying last week, we might. It's good to exercise, but to keep in shape.
That's right.
But I want you to. I don't mean to be so blunt. But to be honest with you. No matter how good a shit you fight to lose a battle.
Amen.
That's right.
That's it.
That's right.
You fight to lose because Angel's gonna win.
Yes.
That was undefeated.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
And come to you and I. Yes. The only person that defeated death was our Lord and Savior Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Other than that, death is undefeated amongst the people of the world.
Amen.
Amen. So no matter how you try, you might it'll prolong your life. And I said there's nothing wrong with eating good and trying. But eventually, you're going to have to pass. And
that's
there's somebody waiting on the other side.
Yes.
And it's Jesus.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And if you have not been dealing with the Lord now, in eternity, it's going to be too late. You know why? Because here in this dispensation, there is grace, there is hope, there is space for repentance.
Amen.
But in the life to come, there is no space for repentance.
Amen.
There are no second chances.
Amen.
You're not going to be able to say, well, Lord, I'm ready to live for you now. God's going to say it's too late. Mm-hmm. Because he said, in life I gave you chances. You heard the gospel. You heard the word of God time after time after time after time. But you put it in the back of your mind. You put it in the back of your heart. Amen. You didn't take heed to the word of God. And this is your life.
Amen.
Now you're going to be eternally separated from it.
Yes.
Because you made your choice. You rejected the word of God.
Amen.
Amen. That's what people do today. They reject the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
So when you see people, oh, Lord, help me. Lord, this.
Yes.
Lord, that. Amen. You know what? Your compassion says, yes. You want to help. You want to do something for them.
Yeah.
And you should. But make no mistake. Amen. The choices that they make. Amen.
Amen.
And put them where they are.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 The choices, I'm not talking about folks who are feeble-minded. Amen. That's different. I'm not talking about that. I'm not talking about children, but children don't have a lot of control over their circumstances. But I'm talking about adults in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. The choices that we make put us in the situation that we're in.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And even though God is a loving God, God is a God of grace, He's a God of mercy. He truly is, in Jesus' name. When you stand before God, if you're not right with God, amen, you're going to be in danger of His wrath.
That's true.
It's that simple.
Amen.
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 We all have to die. We all have to pass away.
That's
Steve
true.
Jobs, another one. All the money in the world. If there was a way physically possible for him not to die, he would have done it.
Oh, yeah.
But he had to die.
Yes.
Amen. All these people, rich or poor, great and small, famous, infamous, anonymous, whatever it is, black or white, Chinese, Russian, Jewish, they're all black, white, they all have to die.
That's right.
That is the one thing we have in common.
Amen. That's
right. So the life that we live, that we spend here on this earth, in this dispensation, should be dedicated.
That's right.
Yes. Amen.
To forming a relationship with the Lord, a real relationship with God.
Yes.
Amen. It ain't good enough to say, well, I went to church.
That's
that
true.
Ain't good enough.
That's true.
Amen. Ain't good enough. A lot of folks in the church, if we really understood how God is, amen,
amen.
If we really understood how God is, amen, we would be shocked. That's why I believe in the Sunday school lesson talk about the terror of the Lord.
Yes.
You got to warn people about the terror of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, we have 7.5 billion people on this earth today. And I'm going to tell you right now, I can say with confidence, the vast majority ain't going.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. You know why I say that? Because the Word of God says it.
Amen.
He said, why does the gate that lead to destruction? And many there go. Now is the gate that lead to life. And few there in the seventh chapter of the book of Matthew. Amen.
Amen.
Enter ye in at the straight gate.
That's right.
The straight gate.
Yes.
The narrow way. If you're looking to go to heaven, don't look for the crowd, because the crowd's not going to
be there. That's right.
Amen.
The crowd has been sold out to the world. Amen?
Amen.
The crowd has sold out to the world.
Yes.
People would rather follow the prosperity gospel than the truth.